Say hey to Tokyo, Rio, De Janeiro. Here we go, go. Hello.
So today we're cooking in my living room. As you can see, that's my dog, Penny. Penny! That's Penny. She's a bull terrier. She kind of, probably you kids would think she looks like the Target dog. Penny! Penny! Yeah! That's my dog. I have another dog somewhere around here named Rigby. Rigby! Rigby! I think he's actually on the floor. Rigby! Rigby, come out. Rigby! I see your tail. Yeah, there he is. There's my Ruru. Rigby. Yep. He does what he wants. Kind of like you guys. You guys just do what you want all the time. But today we're working in my living room. We, as you can see, there's a lot of like Christmas stuff in here. That's my tree. We have blankets that are over the couches. Little snowman up there. I'll show you guys this. My little, I've just been working on some stuff. I just got this from Target. You guys can see. It's a little obnoxious Christmas tree that looks like a unicorn. I'll put him back. Not sure, I was thinking about bringing it to school, but I don't know. And I got these little villages. But today, we're gonna be working on expressions, equations, student handout number 5. Okay, and again, people, you're gonna get 3 sheets. The first one looks like this. The second one looks like this, and the one that's homework will always say homework in the corner. You see that? All right, so in a minute, I'm gonna get situated here, and we're gonna go over solving one-step equations. All right? All right, I'll be right back. Okay. So let's start filling this out. In order to solve an equation, we must isolate the variable and keep each side of the equation balanced. Isolate. You guys know what isolate means? Isolate, to keep alone. To keep alone. Okay? And balance, you know, like a teeter totter or a scale. They have to be on even playing grounds, even. Okay? Okay. We can use the inverse operation to move terms from one side of the equation to the other. Inverse operations can be thought as the opposite or undoing operation. Operations. Okay. What operation is taking place? What is the inverse of that operation? I do not like this font. I think it's very hard to read. Do you guys agree? I think it's hard to read. So if it's addition, we're gonna make this subtraction. If it's subtraction, we make it addition. If it's multiplication, we make it division. Division. Wow, there's three I's in division. I am sometimes a little off. I make division, multiplication. Sorry, my handwriting is awful and I know this, but so it's just the opposite. Inverse operations is subtraction, is addition. Addition is subtraction, division is multiplication, multiplication is division. Okay? Now these kids, we are in for a treat. Remember how I said we cannot combine like terms? Well, that is true. We can't combine like terms, but use the inverse operation to solve each one-step equation below. Okay, ready for the magic? We're going to try to get x by itself. Our whole goal is to get x by itself. So let me write this just on my whiteboard. The goal is to get x by itself. He wants to live alone. I'm living alone. I'm living alone. 10 hero points to any student that knows that quote. When I get old enough, I'm living alone. I'll give you a hint. It's a pretty famous Christmas time movie, okay? I'm living alone. Okay. We need to get x by itself. Well, see the x says 4 times x equals 16. We are going to divide 4 by 4. X equals 16 divided by 4 is 4. Not bad, right? Here's an easier one. X plus 9 equals 13. If we're adding 9, we're really going to subtract 9. Minus 9, minus 9. Just going to draw my line. Not plus 9, minus 9. They cancel each other out. 13, take away 9, is 3. X equals 3. You guys see that? X equals 3 because we got rid of the 9 by subtracting 9 and subtract whatever you do on the one side, you have to do on the other side. So if we subtract 9 on this side, we have to subtract 9 on the other side. So let's just write that down on the whiteboard, okay? What you do to one side, you must do to the other side. So maybe on this side of your paper, you guys should write this rule down. Okay, here, let me turn down the ring light just a little. What you do to one side, you must do to the other side. Okay, take a second, write that down. All right, turning light back on. See that light really kind of makes a difference. So number three, sorry, if it sounds like I'm a little stuffed up, it's because I am. Now remember, addition, subtraction is going to be addition. So if we have a minus 8, we're gonna plus 8 on this side and plus 8 on this side. Now we have x alone. X equals 14 plus 8, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. I don't know about you, I'm feeling 22. Yep, I'm going to probably sing that song every single time we get to an answer that's 22. All right. X over 5 equals 13. Okay, now we have to get X alone. Okay, so when you have X on top over 5, this is a division problem. So we would rather do multiplication, right, kids? So we're gonna times 5 up on the top, times 5 at the bottom, times 5 on the other side, get rid of our 5. X equals 13 times 5 is 65. And Justin just walked in. Here, 1 second. You haven't met Justin yet, guys. Say hi, except for my English guys.
What's up?
Are you playing with your feet, Justin?
No.
Don't play with your feet. That's rude, Justin. That's really rude, Justin. Tell them something inspirational. Tell them to do good in their math.
Do good in math.
Why?
Because it'll be very important when you get older.
How important?
Super important.
You want to uncross your legs? Tell them that... Rigby stole something? Well, that dog, he doesn't listen, does he?
He's your dog.
He's your dog, too.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll go after him. Okay, back to business, kids. Back to business. And I'm sorry, if you can hear my Rigby dog growling, it's because he is. He's kind of my jerk dog, but I love him. So... we have a subtraction problem. We have to make it addition. Negative 6 plus 6 plus 6 on the other side. We can cancel those out. X is equal to 17. All right, this is multiplication because 2 times X is equal to 88. Divided by 2, divided by 2. X is equal to 88 divided by 2 is, well, what's half of 88? 44. First page is done. See, they're not that bad. Not that bad. All right, let's look at number let's take a look here. One-step equations can also include rational numbers. All right, do you guys remember what a rational number is? Rational numbers can be fractions, and I know how much you guys like fractions, so that's where I'm going to take a break, and we're gonna go over this the next time in class, because I have a few things that I want you guys to brush up on in Khan Academy, and we have a quiz too. So sorry, I know this is like kind of like a bad introduction slash ending introduction to rational numbers, but I want to go back over rational numbers just so that way you guys are comfortable with fractions once again, because they're going to keep popping up. And I have some practice for you guys in Khan Academy that will help you with this. And we have a quiz coming up, so that I want to go over with you guys. So that is all for now, and I'll see you in the future. And again, in case no one's told you, thanks for being one of the best parts of my day.
New York, LA, Berlin, say hey to Tokyo.